Today you're going to tell us about a third scientific discovery that seems to suggest the activity of a designing intelligence, and that's the discovery of what's in everybody's body that's watching. That's the discovery of the digital information encoded in DNA. Now, before we talk about this discovery, can you first remind us of why leading scientific atheists think that scientific discoveries undermine belief in God? You have debated most of them. I've heard a lot of the debates, so you know what they are talking about.
Yeah, absolutely. The new atheists are a group of scientists who've been arguing since about 2006, 2007, that science properly understood undermines belief in God. And for them, a key issue is actually the issue of design. One of those key scientific atheists, Richard Dawkins, has said that the universe we observe has precisely the properties we should expect. If at bottom there's no purpose, no design, nothing but blind, pitiless indifference. And he goes on, when he's talking about biology, to say that biology is the study of complicated things that give the appearance of having been designed for a purpose. But for him, the key word is appearance. And the reason that these new atheists or scientific atheists are so confident in their position is they believe that the Darwinian explanation for the appearance of design is right. Because according to Darwin, living things look as though they were designed for a purpose. They have the appearance of design, but they weren't actually designed because there's an unguided, undirected process that produces that appearance. And that process is his idea of natural selection acting on random variations. And modern biologists would now talk about natural selection acting on random mutations. And so, because there's this unguided process that can mimic the powers of a designing intelligence, we don't need to really think about an actual design. We don't have evidence of actual design, and therefore, there's no evidence of design, there's no designer, then belief in God becomes, as Dawkins puts it elsewhere, delusional. We might believe in it to give ourselves comfort, but we have no objective or public evidence of design, only the illusion of design in living things.